Get this figure and more at Lunar Toy Store. Hey, my name is Jobby, and Uncle Phil from Fresh Prince of Bel-Air was the original Shredder voice. Insert joke here, I guess.
Pillowy mounds of mashed potatoes.
The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air was a show that I watch way more than Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Yes, TMNT was another one of those big franchises that I kinda missed the boat on. I think the first piece of turtle media that I saw was that one show with the turtle tits. But I know the basics from pop culture osmosis, Leonardo's the leader, Michelangelo is a party dude, Donatello does machines, and Raphael is Batman. And their arch nemesis, the Shredder, is Uncle Phil. That's really all I know. Now, despite not being some crazy transformer, this guy is a third-party figure, which is why it doesn't say Shredder on the box. This figure is called the First Gouken Orokusaki, which is an intentional misspelling of his real name, Orokusaki. Very insidious copyright dodge, I like it. But this borderline thievery was completely worth it, because the painting and the sculpting on this figure is fantastic. Now it's worth mentioning that out of the box, this guy comes helmetless. So I armed him up and now I feel whole. Despite not knowing much about this character, I was always into his design. Not so much the original Shredder, but the subsequent designs like the TMNT 2001, Nickelodeon TMNT. They always make this character look badass. And this figure is no exception. The design of this figure honors the original design, but it gives him an edgy reimagining, with really cool but ultimately useless panel lining on the armor, and a lot of parts that are dangerously well, he's got the Shredder for a reason, and I'm glad they didn't hold back. But because of that, you legitimately have to be careful, because I'm sure that some of these parts can draw blood, especially because the helmet is actually made out of die-cast metal. This is basically a knife. And using my coat touch technique, I've determined that his boots are also die-cast metal. The die-cast metal parts adds a feeling of quality to the figure, and almost justifies the price. Now let's talk about his cape. I mentioned in my previous review, the Figma Saitama, check it out if you haven't, I mentioned that I love the cape on this guy. That's still true. The material seems strong, and it doesn't seem like it's gonna rip anytime soon. Helps that it's intentionally rip-looking. And the bendy wire makes the cape poseable. And for the most part, this bendy wire feature works extremely well. You can make this thing look absolutely stunning. But now I see why a lot of figures don't incorporate the bendy wire. And I'm sad that the bendy wire on this side of the cape is no more. At least the other side is no problem, and you could still get some sweeping poses. And something else I want to nitpick. His neck is weird, but I guess if his neck wasn't designed like this, he wouldn't have as much range in his posability.
It's too early for that.
As I mentioned earlier, the figure comes with his helmet off, and you can fill in that gaping hole with this toupee. And while his helmetless head doesn't look bad, it just doesn't feel right. It might be the hair. It's the hair. I just don't like the haircut. But now we do get a better look at his head sculpt, and it's fantastic. Some of the best toy ears I've ever seen. So the figure comes with this stand. It's not an action base, but it's some kind of rack with a Foot Clan symbol, I think, and some... I'm sorry, I don't read yellow. So this thing is just one solid plastic piece, and it can hold almost all of his accessories. Except his hands, which includes this pair of fists, and this pair of grabby hands. And you only get one pair of claws, so you have to replace it every time you switch hands. And a great thing about these hands is that they're made out of a flexible plastic, so getting him to hold his weapons is very easy. This sword is... it's just one of those swords that's excessive but ridiculously badass. But it's not die-cast metal, so you can't really cut anything with it.
Too bad.
But that's not all there is to the sword. I might be pushing it with these transformations. What else is there to say about this sword? You also get another purple staff that looks strangely familiar. Matter of fact, all these other weapons look strangely familiar.
Oh my god!
Even though I couldn't give a splinter's ass about the turtles, I fangasm for some reason. To go along with Shredder's redesign, the turtles' classic weapons are rendered in exquisite, but ultimately pointless, mechanical detail. This makes me really excited for what First Gouken might do next. If the next figure in this line is not one of the turtles and, say, Casey Jones, I'd be a little disappointed. But Casey Jones in this style would be really cool. First Gouken, take my money! And for Raphael's size, you get a special pair of hands that allow Shredder, I mean Orokusaki, to hold him like that. I also like the story implication of Shredder having all of their weapons. I guess Uncle Phil finally got that turtle suit. So all of Orokusaki's accessories gives him a lot of playability. And adding to that playability is some deep listen. Posability. Ball joint at the head, ball joint at the base of the neck, allows him to look up that far and look down that far. Shoulder pads move up, they're on a ball joint. Cape is on a bendy wire, as previously mentioned. Rotation at the arm, forward movement, arm moves out. Swivel here. Double bend at the elbow.
Swivel here.
Wrist moves up and down. Chest crunch, which is the only loose joint in the figure. Fuck. At the waist, the loincloth is an actual piece of cloth that doesn't do anything. Unexpected ratchet joints. Leg moves back that far. Beautiful spread. Double bend at the knee, up and down at the ankle, a pivot, and a really tight toe bend. And finally, in order of
Turtle Soup.
Posability on this guy is amazing. There's little limit to what you can do with him. He could even kneel, but I don't recommend it because of his shin spikes. I just wish the cape wasn't broken and the ab crunch could get annoying sometime. But other than that, extremely solid. Another thing that makes this guy fun to play with is his size.
Boy, he big.
Here's Figma Marek Akademi, SH Monster Arts Godzilla, Masterpiece Optimus Prime, and another 80s cartoon villain, the Masterpiece MP36 Megatron. I know they're not related in the slightest, but they do look really good together. And I'm glad to say that overall, this figure's amazing. I have to repeat, I am not a Turtles fan, but I do appreciate the design of Shredder, and this figure not only nails that design, but it goes beyond even that. Not to mention his incredible posability, and this little preview of what's to come, give me the title. Now the figure is labeled as NT02, and obviously NT stands for not transformed, but this figure is so good that it's making me consider getting NT01, which is a figure called Cerebrum, not Crank. But then I stop considering it when I look at the price. Looks like Frisgoken is a luxury line, but for such a high quality figure, it's a bit overpriced. But I could do it. But luckily for me, I didn't have to do anything because the Lunar Toy Store had my back. The first Gouken Arakusaki was part of the final shipment that Lunar Toy Store gave me before the breakup, and they seemed pretty eager to sell this figure. Because unlike the Figma Saitama, which I specifically requested, I didn't ask for Arakusaki, but I'm glad they gave it to me. So if you're a Shredder fan and you have the cash, why not get this figure from the Lunar Toy Store? Maybe the sales they make from this review will remind them of what we used to have. And on the topic of Figma Saitama, just a reminder that if you're a subscriber to Jobby the Hong, you have the chance to win this figure for free. Just gotta wait till the end of the month to see who gets it. As for the first Gouken Arakusaki,
fuck off, he's mine.